These are my top picks from Wet n Wild. They're products that I've used for a very long time. Well, there's probably a couple in here that are fairly new, but they're products that I've used for a really long time, and I love these products from Wet n Wild. Wet n Wild to me is a brand that is kind of on par with e.l.f. I feel like e.l.f. is just a little bit above Wet n Wild, but Wet n Wild, even though it has a few misses in their line, they have some really great products that are under $6, just like e.l.f. And so that's what I'm bringing you today, is my favorite from Wet n Wild that is under $6. If you like these kind of videos, please give it a thumbs up. It really does help me out a lot. And let's get into what I love from Wet n Wild that is under $6 at the drugstore. Okay, I mentioned this very recently in a video, which was my 10 under 10 at the drugstore. Guys, don't hate me for this, but I really like the PhotoFocus foundation from Wet n Wild. I like the matte and I like the Dewy formula too. And in that video, I was talking about how when I got the Dewy formula and I tried it, I really liked the way that it covered. I like the way it sits on my mature skin. I like how long it lasted. It wasn't quite as long lasting as the matte. But what I finally decided to do was to mix the two together, because I do have a very cool color in the matte one, which is the rose ivory. And then I have a very warm color, which is soft ivory, in the Dewy one. And I mixed the two together and it gave me a beautiful neutral shade. And when I did mix the two together, I liked the finish even better than each of them on their own. So I really do like the two. And I really enjoy this foundation all around. A lot of people can't handle this because they say that the original, the matte formula, smells like paint. And I understand what you're talking about, guys. I smell it, but once I get it on my skin, I don't feel like it keeps that fragrance around or anything like that. I feel like it dissipates very quickly. And I really love the way it lays down on my skin. I am wearing it today and I just think it's a beautiful foundation. And I also wanted to make sure that I told you that the Dewy foundation, it doesn't have that smell. It does have a little bit of a smell, but it's nothing like the strong smell that comes out of the original matte formula. So my first pick from them is their foundations. I like both of those. And another thing that I like from that PhotoFocus line is the pressed powder. This powder I have in Natural Buff. It seems to be a really good color for me. It's not too light and it's not too dark. And once I get it on my skin, it just looks like skin. It doesn't look like powder on there. So it's just gonna blend in really well. They have a few different colors on there. I like how soft this is. I like how it feels very, very airy. I don't use a lot of powder in anything I do, but I like powders to be able to refine my pores and to soften my pores. And this is one that does that without having me look any drier. And I just really think it's really pretty. So I will use this one and then I'll put the spray on it, and they meld together just beautifully with the foundation. And it is a powder that I've really enjoyed, and I feel like it's a very perfecting powder, and I've never seen any flashback from it. It's not like an HD powder that's white that's going to give you flashback in camera if you take a picture with a camera that has a flash on it. So really have loved that one from the time that it came out. My next pick from them is the Wet n Wild MegaSlicks lip gloss. I love these lip glosses. I think that they're some of the better glosses in their line. Most of these that I've gotten, they do have a slight shimmer in them, but you guys know that I do like my shimmery glosses. I'm an 80s girl and I like that. I used to have one that was a really super light pink that I just put in the middle, and I don't know where that went. I thought it was in my purse, but it wasn't. So I need to repurchase that one. And let me see if I can see the color on this one for you guys. This one is called Bronze Berry. I feel like this would go for anybody's skin coloring. It's just a really pretty, like, it's like a nude pink with some peach in there. So it could lean you either way on your coloring, and I feel like it could go really well with it. Let me see if I can just darken it up a little bit so that you guys can see that, you know, if you wanted to darken it up, you could. But what a pretty, pretty shine on that. It's so gorgeous. So that one is a winner for me too. Also from their line, another gloss that I really love is the Liquid Catsuit. This is the High Shine Lipstick. The reason that I like this so much is it reminds me a ton of the Anastasia Beverly Hills lip glosses. And I love those because they're such an opaque, pretty formula. And this is exactly the same. This is what I have on today. It is a not a super high shine formula though, even though it says it is. It's not like a beaming glassy look on your lips. I do have it on right now and I don't feel like it gives me that super shine that I'm used to with other glosses. So it stays a little bit longer and they have a ton of colors in this too. And this is really good on my mature lips for not bleeding at all. I'm kind of getting to the point to where my lip lines are driving me crazy about bleeding at times, but this one is thick enough without being too like goopy, if you know what I mean. Sometimes you get a really tacky, goopy gloss. It's not like that, but it's thick enough that it won't bleed out of the lines for me. So I really like that. And this one is called Flirt Alert. So that's really pretty pink, very cool toned, but they have a ton of colors and I have tried several different of them, but the Flirt Alert is my favorite color, obviously because it is that blue toned pink. Okay, another thing that throws way back. I actually had to go buy a new one of these because my old one looked really bad and the top was broken. And so I went and bought a new one just for this video, but this is the Dolce de Leche contour palette from them. This is such a great powder, you guys. If you're looking for a bronzer that isn't too warm, isn't too cool, this is a really, really good one, you guys. I'm building it up a lot here, but I do have it on as my bronzer today, and you can see that I don't look orange. It just looks natural on me, and I love that about it. So you can really dust it out, and you can make it look really natural. Or if you have darker skin, you can bump it up and make it look like a really beautiful sun-kissed glow. The other thing that I love on this is this banana powder on this side. They don't list this as a banana powder, but you guys, to me, it is. It's one of those powders that if you were stuck somewhere and you needed to set your makeup all over, it's gonna fit that bill for you, no problem. As a matter of fact, I think it's very much like the PhotoFocus powder. It has that same consistency. It feels buttery, it feels soft. It doesn't feel drying. I really like these powders in here. And again, if you have a lighter complexion like I do, you can swirl them together, which is actually what I do. I swirl them together and then I get a really light, super light sun-kissed glow. But if you're, you know, more along the lines of being medium to dark, you might really just go into this one and be able to get that really sun-kissed look on your face. But this has been around for a long time. It says contour, but it's really not contour. I do like that it has on the back of here where you can place your bronzer to make it look very natural and to help you, you know, if you want to, you can use it to carve out your cheekbones a little bit. It wouldn't look bad at all, especially if you put a blush on top of it, it'd look fine. But this isn't right. This isn't the right color for me to be able to contour with, but as far as a bronzer, it is spot on and I love it. And I've used this one for years and years too. Wet n Wild Color Icon Blushes just went through recently a new revamping on the way they look. And I actually like them packaged better as this. And this one is, let's see, this one is Pearlescent Pink. And a lot of you probably already have this in your collection, but I've always liked their blushes, but I felt like they were just a little bit too on the sparkly side. They calmed that down in this one. It's not nearly as in your face as it used to be. And I really like how it just gives you just a really soft flush. And then again, you can build it up to where it is the same color as what's in the pan if you want to. And it's a soft blush. This is a perfect, perfect neutral color. It is the perfect sweet spot between peach and pink. And like I said, you can see right there that there's no shine in that really. It's very satiny, very natural looking blush. And I love what they did with the new packaging. I wasn't a huge fan of the square one. I don't know why. I guess I wasn't a huge fan of the square one because I always felt like it was just too shimmery a blush for me. And I need my blush to be just a little bit more along the lines of satin so that if I want to wear a highlighter on the top, I can. Now, as far as the Color Icon palettes, I love these little things, you guys. They're great. This one is the Cosmic Collision. I wear this all the time. Today I'm wearing one of the colors in here, which is this color right here, to darken up my outer corner of my eyes. And it is a really dark color. In the pan, it looks very purple and it looks like it has a lot of glitter in it, but it doesn't really when you get it on your finger like this. So out of all of their little 10 pan palettes, this one's my favorite. I actually Shouldn't have closed that yet. I love this color right here on the lid. I love that they put these blue and green colors in here, and I love this deep dark burgundy color right here. And then this one is one of their little four quads, and this one is called Petalette. And my pink in here is broken, so please forgive me for that. But as far as all of these colors go, they worked so well together. They did such a good job on picking these colors out to complement each other. It is what I have on my eyes today, and it all just looks so pretty. They're not like super stark colors that you are going to have to blend and blend and blend. They go on softer, so you need to build them up if you like a more stark look. But if you just like a really light look, a really, you know, soft wash of color, this one is so good, and I love it's in the plummy shades. I love that this color up here is a very neutral color, and then this is a cool palette, as you can tell, very cool toned palette, and it's just right up my alley, and it was just exactly what I wanted for today as far as my pink shirt went, because this color matched it so well. This color is so metallic and so vibrant right there, and it's what I have on my lids. And so this one right here is my favorite as far as those little four quads go, and of course it'd have to be purple, obviously. And then the last product I talk about constantly on my channel, if you've been with me any amount of time, and that is these two huge pans. They are actually called the Two Reflect Shimmer Palettes. They're not a palette. I think the reason that they call them a palette is because they're so big. But this one is, I'll have a Cosmo, and they are Baked Swirled Highlighters. And then this one is Boozy Brunch. And these have been around, gosh, you guys, I don't even know how long these have been around, but they are such gorgeous highlighters. And let me go ahead and try them on my other arm for you. So this one, Boozy Brunch, it is very gold, but at the same time, it almost has this duochrome look of having like, I don't know, you can see the pink and the gold and the little tiny bit of the bronze in there. So beautiful. And it's just glass-like. There's nothing highlighter chunky about these at all. And then this one is, I'll have a Cosmo. This one is my favorite because you can see like I've worn it down. I've almost cut it even with the pan. This is my favorite because it is that peachy pink color that just is so lovely on the skin. And the colors for being that glass-like texture, holy moly, there's the I'll have a Cosmo right here, and then Boozy Brunch right here. And you guys, you can't go wrong with these. And look at those. There's like, you can't see any glitter particles. You can't see any texture. This is way before the whole highlighting craze hit the world. These were what you wanted, and they are so absolutely gorgeous. And I would highly, highly recommend those. And that is my last product from Wet n Wild that is under $6 that I would recommend to you. You guys, this is a great line, but like I said, there are a few hits, there are a few misses, and there are some that were right in between there too that I just didn't make it into my top ones, but I'm sure that you probably have some that you love that I didn't mention in here. Let me know those in the comment section below, because I'd always love to try things that you guys recommend for me. I appreciate that so much. I hope that everybody is doing good. Thank you so much for joining me today. Hope that everybody is keeping their sanity in the middle of all this chaos that we're in right now. Stay well, stay safe, stay sanitized. I love you very much, and I will talk to you in my very next video. Bye, you guys.